A longtime sticking point between the U.S. and Israel surfaced once again today during the president's visit, stealing a little bit of the spotlight during his major speech in Jerusalem.
Like debate.
The interruption came when President Obama was speaking to Israeli young people about a brighter future, when a heckler brought back some sour memories of the past, shouting at President Obama to free Jonathan Pollard.
I believe your future is bound to ours. No. This is part of the lively debate that we talked about. This is good.
Pollard, an American convicted of spying for Israel, has served nearly three decades in a U.S. prison. And there have been protests in Israel this week demanding his release. Before his Middle East trip, President Obama was asked about Pollard in an interview with Israel's Channel 2.
This is an individual who committed a very serious crime here in the United States. He's been serving his time. I have no plans for releasing Jonathan Pollard immediately. But what I am going to be doing is to make sure that he, like every other American who's been sentenced, is accorded the same kinds of review.
This is a story I've covered from day one. In 1989, I even wrote a book about it, Territory of Lies. Jonathan Pollard was a civilian analyst for U.S. Naval Intelligence with access to some of this country's most important secrets. He started passing some of those secrets to an Israeli operative, receiving monthly cash payments. In 1985, he was questioned about the removal of classified documents and was placed under surveillance. But Pollard and his then-wife Anne were arrested after trying and failing to gain entrance to the Israeli embassy in Washington. Pollard made an agreement with prosecutors. He pleaded guilty to one count of conspiracy to commit espionage. That allowed the Reagan administration to avoid a trial and the need to release any sensitive or classified information. In exchange, the U.S. attorney worked out an arrangement that Pollard would receive a substantial sentence, but not the maximum sentence, life. Yet in a stunning turnabout, a U.S. federal judge rejected the plea agreement and did sentence Pollard to life, citing the enormous damage to U.S. national security that then-Defense Secretary Caspar Weinberger outlined in a classified memo to the court. Pollard remains at a federal prison in North Carolina.